Dear students, today we learn a square pyramid 35 mm sides of base and 65 mm axis length rest on HP and one of its edges of the base which is inclined to VP at 30 degree. Draw the projections of the pyramid when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degree. So for this problem, we see the solid edge procedure as well as how to draw manually also. In between I will tell the how to draw manually also. So anyhow, you are all well versed with how to draw manually. Okay, only important points we will take. Okay, let's see the solid edge software procedure. So select a thin line. So first you draw XY line, let name it. So this is X, Y, VP, HP. So next, a square pyramid 35 mm sides of base and 65 mm axis length rest on HP on one of its edges of the base. So there is a square pyramid, the base edges are 35 mm and axis height is 65 mm. So first we will draw the top view and we assume it is resting on its base on HP. So it should be edges of the base. So the resting edge should be on our right side. That is the thumb rule we made in an orthographic projection of solids. So draw a square, it's a square pyramid, so four sides. Let use the smart dimension command. So this is 35 mm. Use equal option. So make all sides are equal. Okay. Next, in the top you can see the slant edges of the pyramid. So join the opposite corners or diagonals. Now we'll name it. So we'll keep it little bit closer to XY line. Now we'll name the base corners. This is A, B, C, D and axis O, inside the bracket O1. Okay, then draw a vertical projectors. Again use the thin line. So draw a vertical projectors. Okay. Now this is the direction of the projector. Next, select a visible line style, draw a base of the pyramid. So here axis length is 65 mm. Smart dimension, and this is axis length 65 mm, and the axis line style must be center line type, then visible line style, connect the corners to the apex point. Now this is O dash, this one will be O1 dash. So here A dash inside the bracket D dash, and this B dash inside the bracket C dash. Okay. So draw the projections of the pyramid when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degrees. So the next step. So here the axis must be inclined to HP at 45 degrees. So first draw, use move command, move and copy. Select this. So select B dash C dash, that is the edge we consider as a resting edge. So select B C as a resting edge, place it here. Okay, then use the rotate. Now this is the B dash C dash. Now we'll select AD. So it should be inclined to HP, axis should be inclined to HP at 45 degrees. So base also inclined to HP at 45 degrees. Okay. We'll repeat the procedure. Rotate. So this is the center of rotation. This is the point to rotate. So rotation angle 45 degree and position angle. Okay. Let me check angle between. Okay, 45 degree. Okay. So while drawing manually in a sketchbook, so arbitrarily select one point B dash C dash, name it as a B dash C dash. Then measure B to O. So B to O you cut the arc. Then, sorry, I'll repeat. So arbitrarily mark on B dash C dash. Then measure B to A. B to A. So B to A, that is 35 mm. You cut the arc. I'll draw a line for incline to HP at 45 degree. Since your axis is inclined to HP 45, so here this is 90 degree, so this is also 45. So 45, 45, 90 plus this is a perpendicular. So this is 90. Total, if you consider this is a triangle, then that is called, the triangle will be 180 degree. So base must be inclined to HP at 45 degree. So after drawing this, then measure this length. From here you cut the arc, from A you cut the arc and complete this. Then measure B to O, B to O you mark it here, then draw a center line type. That's how we draw in manually while drawing. Okay. Now here we'll adjust the space which is required for the final. So if you don't switch off this, so that is the problem we face. We'll get the double sketches. Okay. Then, so select normal line style or a thinner line. So draw a vertical projectors from all the points. And from here, draw a horizontal projectors. Okay. Now, so first we'll name the intersection points. So this is A. so a is here, so this is a, this is b, and this is c, and this is d, and this is o. Next o1, so this is o1. Okay, now first complete the boundary and make it visible line style. So line command, visible line. So boundary of the sketch, so A to B, B to O, next O to C, we need to select intersection points. If intersection point is not showing, cancel the midpoint and switch on the intersection points. Okay, the boundary of the sketch. Next, so this is O. O dash. So when you see from the top, observer will be here. OA and OD is the topmost edges. Make those edges are visible. So O to A and O to D, make it visible. Then BC is the resting edge, so that must be hidden. So what we'll do, so we'll zoom this portion using trim command, trim this line, then use the and trim this line also. Next line command, so this is the axis line, hidden edge style, and one more here is the axis line O2 O1. Now this is the hidden edge, so we use the dashed line type, and this is axis line, use the chain type. Okay, so this is O1. Okay, fine. So this is how it appears when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degree. Then last edge, so one of its edges of the base which is inclined to VP at 30 degree. Now BC we have taken as a resting edge, so we'll make it inclined to VP at 30 degree. So first, so here when you check BC edge, so the dimension is same as a original length, then no need to draw a locus. So we tilt the resting edge BC inclined to VP at 30 degree. So first you draw a line for given inclination, that is VP at 30 degree. Okay, then we move this. So for a better view, we'll zoom this portion, then make move and copy. Now the resting edge must be inclined to VP at 30 degree. I will take it as a reference end B as a reference. So we'll place it somewhere here. Okay. Then use the rotation command. So for better view, we'll zoom this portion, rotate, select the elements, now B as a center of rotation and C as a point to rotate from, click on here. Okay, so suppose it's going outside the boundary printable area, we'll move little bit upper, use the move command, select the sketch. Okay, so select any one point, move nearer to or adjust it. Okay, so here some letters. Okay, this is A. Okay, now the final portion, remove the unwanted lines. Okay, then use the thin line style, that is normal. So draw a vertical projectors. And horizontal projectors, that is O. Next, A. Next, B. Next, C. Next, D. And O1. O1. So draw a vertical and horizontal projectors. Okay. Now some unwanted lines we can trim it. So this is not required, this edge. So that is a little bit confusing. Okay. Now we'll draw a front view. When the edge is inclined to VP at 30 degree and axis is inclined to HP at 45 degree. So now first we draw the boundary of the sketch. Now this is A. Okay, start from here, A. And this end point is B. This is C. And this is D. And this is A. Then B to will type letters and naming also. So A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, O1 dash, O dash. Then boundary, so B to O is the boundary, O to D is boundary. Okay, next, so these two edges are visible, the mutually perpendicular or the another third edge which is passing from here, that is also visible line. And here AO is nearest to the observer, so this is visible. Then C is behind the solid and ABCD face is visible, so C will be behind that. We'll make it hidden. C to O. So two visible edges do not cross like this, so it must be hidden line style. Then line center line type, that is O to O1. So O1 dash. Okay, center line type. Sorry, here I named it as a O1. It is a O dash. Okay. So this is the complete solution for a square pyramid, 35mm size of base and 65mm axis length, rest on HP and one of its edges of the base which is inclined to VP at 30 degree. So this is the 30 degree incline. Then draw the projection of the pyramid when the axis is inclined to HP at 45 degree. Okay, so this is the solution. Thank you for watching. So here we show the angle. Okay, this is 30 degree. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग।